Just not in that. As well as the public that we've been able to meet with all of the following hoteliers, starting on March 17th, we met with the runway, and we finished up yesterday with three hoteliers. We had an opportunity to discuss the issues that were addressed with their facility. We had corrective action plans coming back from all eight. We actually have one corrective action plan back already. We had good dialogue going with those hoteliers. We identified any other problems. We have direct contact people that we can meet with. As a matter of fact, some of the hoteliers have flown in people from their corporate offices far away in Houston, Texas, in Columbus, Ohio. So I'm proud to report at Crown Council that we'll be receiving all these corrective action plans within the next 2 weeks. And those corrective action plans, that we will hold the hotels accountable and to make sure that we cut down really not only the number of calls that were being made to our police department and taxing our assets within the town, but making sure there are more safe environments for visitors coming into the town of Maryville. So with that,
anybody have any questions?
Thank you.
coming up with you.
Okay.
They're going to discuss the
Thank you. This was a proven utility. So that was went through the year building a study program in 22 to get away from getting away from that. Thank you. of East Chicago and Chicago. At least other options to look at potential recalls. Time must be called in for that space only all. Time and place will be all the total cost ranges for about 19 million dollars. And this is total cost that that cost include different items, including land, which is subject to negotiation as well. I know our town manager has been getting appraisals for those, and we have that committee. We should have had a yellow handout that I know summary. We have that estimate over the next 7 months, and it's not my own piece, right? And that would be some number that you could respond to with regards. And so the range as is based on somewhere around 19 million, and total development about 30 million. But that should really cost, if you take a line down that's going to be in the factors, the building cost ranges somewhere around 15.5 to 22 million. This is just a building itself. We have also a next step in the report that we have identified as a result of our last meeting. We start signing the committee, started talking about the next step, defining more. So we made a couple of changes into the next process, and I will go ahead and obviously what I will do is turn my team a video sort of update as a draft version of the next step. And the next what we have to do is the draft page. Thank you. town halls. So there are these things that come up. And the more additional work that can be done there is what we cannot. And currently, for example, you can get some grants, you can get a lot of donations that each one of those loans that come into the plenty of deliberations and the uses that cost to cover and make the facility more feasible to take the market. Something that needs to be not the most felt that for the first time in the system. Budget is probably over total budget.
Square foot cost. It really is. I agree 100% with you.
39,000 square feet with a 3,042 square footage line and an 18 call. What's the building that you're getting at? I understand that, so I'm starting to see the debt bill. Some of those calls, $129,000 for a quarter, $129,000 for that fence. That's the right word. $129 per square foot. The phone calls, my calls, is significant because it's beginning to set up the site. I mean, it's a great opportunity that are expecting full cost.
I will say a couple of things. First of all, we're at a very preliminary stage right now. The building is conceptual. This is a budget that we're developing for the project. This is not a big cost that you would have a contract committed for. But it's with all due respect, it's also in front of us. And so in Bruce, you know, going out on a capital campaign, I'm just involved in a capital campaign for the Chamber Acquisition Office. So we went through the same thing with a business loan and how much we want to generate and what we go out and present to the Barbara White Foundation, to Mexico, to whoever. And we got the idea. We got to have something that someone has right now. You know, acquisition of the land, you know, I would consider this the president of Utah to be in Broadway to support the acquisition of the land. That's one idea that we could go out and we could use this funds for this land acquisition if the difference goes up that far. But the construction cost and another thing to keep in mind, obvious and very obvious, is when this does go to build, this is going to have to be a union job in all facets, HVAC, electric, plumbing, carpentry, everything. It's all union in Idaho. And we have 14 union halls in this town, and we're going to have to look at what those rates are about.
Well, this is based on union rates. This is based on union output and action codes. This is based on a type of construction that is not necessarily the lowest cost construction. It's not a metal building. It's a permanent kind of precast concrete masonry building. So there are definitely things that if you're looking to lower the cost of construction, you can lower the cost of material that's being built on. Again, we're not past any more than a conceptual level. And I will tell you that the cost of construction in Northwest Indiana on public projects is very similar, though slightly less, maybe 3% less than the Chicago land area cost of construction of public projects. And we have three records of things under construction currently in the Chicago land area that are all around the same square foot cost. Slightly more, but right around the same square foot cost. So this budget is also budgeting for something that would start construction in the 2019-2020 season. So it's got some escalation built into the number you're looking at. And if the project were to go beyond that, you'd still need to be adding additional escalation per year. So again, I think we're being maybe a little bit conservative, but not out of the realm conservative. Again, it's a high cost construction, but you're a public body. You're dealing with union construction. You're meeting all the current codes, both EDA, energy codes, and other things. So you're right, it's a lot of money.
When you bring around 2019 or 2020, you could start that with the cost to go up with inflation.
After those years, the cost, I would budget 3% per year for inflation.
Okay.
So if this budget started in 2022, you need to add a few years worth of inflation.
That's
something that you can be actually applicable to the building cost.
Right.
Which could be a
lot of stuff. You need to just go up every year.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, President, I've served on the committee with Roxanne. We had top neighbors in the schools and the region chamber, and I tried to think of, we had how many spaces do you have?
Three?
Four.
Who's the old one?
The big one.
Yeah.
A restaurant, a fashion
store. Okay, so the only person on the committee.
Spencer Bank had an upset on the committee. What lodging had an upset? What companies did you have?
I don't remember. I think tonight, Mr. President, correct me if Rock Center on North Broadway. In fact, he connected the study to the descriptive site and the study that was presented. I will follow up with something else.
Motion by Councilman Bailey, second by Councilwoman Yenzel, that we accept the site and the feasibility study at this time. Is there any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I think the motion, Mr. President, is going to go to Mrs. Stepanoff on this bill. Given the fact that this professional services bill is their requirement that the contract is larger than a certain amount, we need to get RFPs and three quotes. I make the motion that Jim and Bruce put together an RFP for architectural professional services for this building and present it back to the council.
Motion by Councilman Bailey, second by Councilwoman Yenzel, and Bruce and Jim and the attorney. I can tell you right now that you're probably only looking like $35,000 for somebody to do what we wanted to for us to get going. Sort of setting plans, doing some fire engineering out there, preparing
protective services, like $25,000 or more. That's what the statute is going to do. It's more than $25,000, you have to get three quotes, or three bids, however you want to call it.
Do professional services and monetary bids. We never hired an attorney that way. We've never hired an attorney or engineers that way.
But we got a cost concern here.
Thank you. and we watch boys and girls come up to the table, and they will, women can be a participant as opposed to a spectator. How's this not a spectator sport?
Well, I got it.
table those if we have any inquiries or anything with regard to the Carriage House property.
No. The police commission meeting is
for the sunset 2018 at 8 a.m. The next town council meeting will be April 10th, 2018 at 6:30. We will have a discussion as to when we're going to have a workshop on that. I'm waiting.